Hi students, how are you? I hope you are following the instructions, guidelines which have been issued by government. Stay safe at home. Students, we have already completed the entire theory portions of paper number 13. Today we are going to discuss the topic from paper number 13, that is phase equilibria. All of we know the heterogeneous system. Now, what is heterogeneous system? The system which consisting more than one number of phase in equilibrium with each other is called as heterogeneous system. Now, how many number of phases are in equilibrium depends upon temperature, pressure, composition conditions, and how many number of phases are in equilibrium at different conditions can be conveniently studied with the help of Gibbs phase rule. That Gibbs phase rule can be stated as sum of the number of phases and number of degrees of freedom exceeds number of component by 2, provided that equilibrium between any number of phases should not be disturbed by any means. Any means means by stirring, by mechanical treatment, by electrical treatment, by surface action. That means this can be also written as P is equal to C minus P plus 2. Now here P means number of phases, F degrees of freedom, and C number of components. Now let us see term involved in the Gibbs phase rule. The first term is phase. Now what is phase? Phase is nothing but physically distinct, mechanically separable part of system from other part by definite bounding surfaces is called as phase. Now it can be studied by considering some examples. Consider this particular system. Ice is in equilibrium with water, is in equilibrium with vapor. Now in this case, ice is a solid phase, water is a liquid phase, and vapor is a gaseous phase. That means this particular system consists of three phases. Three phases are in equilibrium. Now here, ice is a solid phase, can be separated from water phase, and gas can be also separated from water phase. That means by definite bonding surfaces we can separate these three phases. If you consider another example, that is calcium carbonate in equilibrium with calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Now here calcium carbonate is a solid phase, calcium oxide is a solid phase, and carbon dioxide is a gaseous phase. Each solid constitutes separate phase. This is very important. Each solid constitutes separate phase, and that's why two solid phases and one gaseous phase, and therefore this system also consists of three phases. Now consider the another term, that is component. Now it can be defined as smallest number of independently variable constituent by means of which composition of each phase participating in the state of equilibrium can be expressed directly or in the form of chemical equation. Here, 0 and negative numbers are also permitted. Now, to study this particular aspect, again consider the example that is ice, water and vapor. This particular system. Now, three phases are in equilibrium here. Now, in order to express composition of each phase participating in the state of equilibrium, only one chemical individual is sufficient, that is H2O. By means of H2O chemical individual, we can express composition of ice, we can express composition of water, we can express composition of vapor, because in ice the chemical individual is water only, because water molecules are bonded by hydrogen bonding. In water, water molecules are there, and vapor also water molecules are there, and therefore here the system is one component. If you consider this particular system, solid Ki in equilibrium with solution of it. Now here this particular system required two chemical individuals to express composition of each phase participating in the state of equilibrium. Which are these two chemical individuals? One is a Ki and another is H2O. If you want to express composition of this solid Ki, we can use Ki plus 0H2O. Ki plus 0H2O. That means with the help of these two chemical individuals, we can express composition of this solid phase Ki. And if you want to express composition of this solution phase, what we can do? Ki plus H2O. Ki plus H2O. It forms solution. And therefore, to express composition of this solution pairs, we require these two chemical individuals, Ki and water. And therefore, this is called as two component system. If we take another example, that is calcium carbonate in equilibrium with calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Now, to express composition of each phase participating in the state of equilibrium, here also it required any two chemical individual, either calcium carbonate and calcium oxide, or calcium oxide and carbon dioxide, or calcium carbonate or carbon dioxide. With the help of these two chemical, any two chemical individual, we can express composition of each phase participating in the state of equilibrium in the form of chemical equation. In the form of chemical equation. Now suppose we want to express composition of calcium carbonate with the help of these two chemical individuals, by selecting these two chemical individuals, CaO and CO2, we can write this CaO plus CO2. If you want to express composition of this calcium oxide by using these two chemical individuals, we can write calcium oxide plus 0 CO2. If you want to express composition of this phase carbon dioxide in this equilibrium by selecting these two chemical individuals, we can write calcium oxide plus CO2, 0 calcium oxide plus CO2. In this way, by selecting any two chemical individuals, we can express composition of each phase participating in the state of equilibrium. Now let us see the third term involved in this Gibbs phase rule, that is degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom. Now it can be defined as minimum number of variable factors which are to be fixed in order to define system completely at equilibrium. Minimum number of variable factors like temperature, pressure, compositions, which are to be fixed or stated in order to define system completely at equilibrium. Now this can be studied by taking examples. Now suppose if you want to define volume of a given mass of gas, with the help of this equation, PV is equal to आर टी. नाउ वन मोल ऑफ गैस, द वॉल्यूम ऑफ वन मोल ऑफ गैस कैन बी डिफाइंड बाय स्टेटिंग प्रेशर एंड टेम्परेचर. प्रेशर एंड टेम्परेचर, दैट मीन्स टू डिफाइन वॉल्यूम वी हैव टू स्टेट दिस टू वेरिएबल्स, प्रेशर एंड टेम्परेचर. Because volume depends upon pressure and temperature. Unless we state pressure and temperature, we cannot define volume of gas. Therefore, this particular system is having 2 degrees of freedom because 2 number of variables are to be stated or fixed in order to define system completely at equilibrium. Now let us see another example. Suppose we want to define solubility of NaCl. Solubility of NaCl. As we know, the solubility of NaCl depends upon temperature. Now suppose we have data, that is at 20 degrees centigrade, suppose that solubility is 5 grams per liter. At 30 degrees centigrade, suppose it is 10 gram per liter. At 40 degrees centigrade, suppose it is 20 gram per liter. And if somebody asks to you, what is solubility of NaCl? Now, as here we have 3 solubilities at 3 different temperatures, and therefore we don't have answer. And if somebody asks to you, what is solubility of NaCl at 30 degrees centigrade? Then you will have definite answer, that is 10 gram per liter. That means in order to define solubility of NaCl, we have to state temperature. Unless stating temperature, we cannot define we cannot define the solubility of NaCl. That's why this particular system having 1 degrees of freedom. 1 degrees of freedom. Another example, if you consider this particular system, ice in equilibrium with water, in equilibrium with vapor. Now this particular system need not require any variable to fix to define at equilibrium, because this is self-explanatory system, because its variable automatically fixed, and that's why its degree of freedom is zero. If degree of freedom is zero, it is called as non-variant system. Non-variant system. If degree of freedom is one, it is called as univariant system. If degree of freedom is two, it is called as bivariant system. Next part. True equilibrium. Now what is true equilibrium? The equilibrium which can be achieved from either direction. From either direction is called as true equilibrium. Now to explain that particular true equilibrium, let us consider we have here ice and water, and here we have this equilibrium, ice and water. Now this is true equilibrium. This equilibrium can be achieved by partial melting of ice, or this equilibrium can be achieved by partial freezing of water. That means at 0 degree centigrade we can obtain this equilibrium by partial melting of ice or partial freezing of water, and therefore it is called as true equilibrium. Now another thing is metastable equilibrium. Metastable equilibrium. Now this equilibrium is a temporary equilibrium. This equilibrium is temporary equilibrium, and this can be achieved from only one direction. This can be achieved from only one direction. For example, we can obtain
water at minus 4 degree centigrade, that is super cooled water, by only careful freezing of water, careful cooling of water. That means if we cool water carefully without seeding, without disturbing that thing, instead of getting ice at 0 degree centigrade, we still obtain water at minus 4 degree centigrade. But this water is in metastable state, because this can be only achieved by careful cooling of water. This equilibrium cannot be obtained from this direction, because when we increase temperature of ice at minus 4 degree centigrade, we still get ice, and at 0 degree centigrade we will obtain water, and therefore this equilibrium cannot be obtained from this direction. This can be achieved from only this direction. Now next thing, in order to study equilibrium conditions of phases, we require a diagram that is called as phase diagram. With the help of phase diagram, we can explain the heterogeneous system or number of phases at equilibrium. Now we have different phase diagrams. Now to draw phase diagram, we should know the conditions of the component. Now let us consider the one component system. Now tell me, what is one component system? As we know, smallest number of independently variable constituents by means of which we can express composition of each phase participating in the state of equilibrium. That means what? One component system means what? One chemical individual is required to express composition of each phase participating in the state of equilibrium. Now suppose this one component present in one phase. Then number of degrees of freedom becomes component 1, phase 1, that means 2. That means degrees of freedom becomes 2. Now in order to define system, we require two variable terms, variable factors. That means by stating two variables, we can define system. Or suppose this one component is present in three phases, then 1 minus 3 plus 2, that is equal to 0. Degree of freedom becomes 0. That means no any variable to fix in order to define system completely. That means minimum degrees of freedom 0, maximum degrees of freedom 2. That means to define or to explain one component system, we require two variables diagram. That means diagram of two variables. And of course, that diagram is pressure temperature diagram. Now